Hey YouTube, Alan here with another gameplay, and today we're going to be taking a look at Bayonetta 2 on the Wii U, a Wii U third party sort of exclusive. Crazy talk. So here we are, I'm Bayonetta and I'm in Link's lovely getup, and we're just taking a quick look at the first level. I've completed the game, so that's why I have Link's costume on, and I've got gear that you wouldn't normally have, like these swords. You get them further on in the story. Anyway, what am I doing? So, in this first level, you have a bit of a world that you can explore, but primarily in Bayonetta, it's kind of like a modern iteration of a hack and slash game. And I'm looking at, I can't remember if there's a challenge up here or not. There's a challenge somewhere in this first area. Nope, there was just a hidden item there. Ah, well. And sorry, yeah, I was saying, so you kind of move from area to area and you beat up a lot of bad guys. You wail on them, basically. But on top of that, there's also hidden areas, and there's things like this mausoleum, or whatever the hell, I can't pronounce that, where you do separate challenges. They're kind of optional. You don't have to do them if you just want to go through the story and complete them. But they're fun enough to do. And that's the thing, the combat in this game is fun. So the goal of here is to defeat all the enemies within the time limit. Relatively straightforward. And one of the big things about Bayonetta is the witch time. If you dodge at the right time, you engage what's known as witch time. There we go. So that's why the screen kind of slowed down. You've seen the clock and you can do more damage and whatnot. It's very much a case of using the, I'm using the Pro Controller, as I often do with Wii games. So there was a pure platinum medal. And we got another, we got a mega green herb. The herbs can be used to do things like give you health back and make you invincible for a short while, up your attack power and whatnot. And you can also get ingredients just for destroying the scenery that can you can use to kind of mix together to make different lollipops, which are the herb lollipops. Yeah, crazy to think that Nintendo not only helped fund this game after everyone else bailed out, despite, you know, people so much wanting a sequel, but then they let them, I'm not going to say tart up Bayonetta in Nintendo gear, but that's kind of what it was. I think it was a picture system, or I guess not. Oh, there is. I knew there was. Well, it's not a treasure chest, it's... Da-da-da-da. But it acts like a treasure chest when you got the Link thing on. So, oh, I've skipped the story intro because I figure that'll get flagged on YouTube. You get some of this... When you're wearing the Zelda costume and the other Nintendo costumes, you tend to get a few other changes, like sound effect changes and attack changes and whatnot. Ordinarily you'd have to walk here, but thankfully I have my fish form, which you get from later on in the game too. I think I actually could have skipped this, I could have just swam over it, but hey, what would be the point of skipping it? You're meant to... Oh, there we go, I just dodged your man at the last second and I got the witch time. These are just kind of nuisance enemies. Ordinarily you, there's my Umbra climax, which is kind of your mega attack. Ordinarily, Bayonetta collects halos off the angels. But when you got the Zelda costume on, Link, on the Zelda, you collect rupees, which is another nice touch. Oh, we got another pure platform, which is good. And here's another challenge. You can see they got cleared, because I've cleared all the challenges already. I've also got all the collectibles except for one. There's this crow. You collect crows to give you heart, essentially increase your health. And he's an absolute nightmare. He unlike all the... I'll focus on that later. Shit. Gotta focus because you can only deal damage in which time in this one. Torture attacks are new as well when you can inflict a lot of damage in kind of a sort of cutscene attack. That was probably too slow to get a platinum, so it'll probably be a gold. I got another lollipop to pick up. Oh no! There we go. Well, this is the first level, so it's a bit easier. The challenge does pick up quite a bit by the end of the game. And you can see there, when the loading is going on, you can try out various kind of combo moves and whatnot. There's a lot. But luckily, like the best kind of pseudo hack and slash game, you can just get away with just whacking away. You know, doing your light attack or your heavy attack. Which is what it boils down to. It reminds me of God of War in that way, where you have light and heavy attack. Oh, there's another health and chest thing. Da-da-da-da. You ordinarily can't swim through this section the first time around, and it's a lot slower. So I'm glad I can do that. I think it's in the trap, yeah. Where did they go? It's a fairly full concentration type of game though. It's not something that you can commentate on all that easy. So if I'm kind of losing my train of thought, that's why. But I also mean that in a good way, because it does kind of keep you focused. Oh, look for your platform, nice. I'm not going to go in there, but that's basically the shop. I have nothing that I can afford to buy. I've only got 20,000 rupee halos. If you destroy the scenery, you can pick up more bits of that. Oh. I think I wasn't meant to be like there at that point in time. I got a little too far ahead than the cutscene I think expected. So to me, this does have a vibe of games like Streets of Rage and Final Fight, albeit with modern production values. We've got the Master Sword on the back there. You know, where you go from area to area, beat up the very bad guy and move on to the final boss. Might have been a bit early to use the urban climax. So you can see your man with the stars is kind of stunned, so a good time to wail away on him. I believe more people have done it yet. I remember that. The kind of spin attack is quite handy for clearing away crowds. There we go, that one worked as well, I think. That's the which time. You can also play as other characters eventually in the game. And they don't. Ah, combo failed me on the platinum, but another platinum, that's good. Eventually you can play as another character. Or characters. But they don't necessarily have which time, they got different attributes. Now that I think on it, I've been whacking away with the sword and kind of a whip type of thing. Bayonetta is known for her big guns, and yet not using those at all. You still have a gun when you detach them from your arms and legs, as weird as that sounds. You can shoot away with your Y button. I have a feeling this is quite a tricky, or a relatively tricky challenge. Oh no, it's not, just restore the timer. I thought it was don't get hit. I know some of them are don't get hit. Oh no, I didn't get it. Well, actually, I'm going to jinx myself again, I know. The first level has got quite a few challenges in it. There's a few that are just boss battles and, you know, a few chapters that are just boss battles. So there might only have one section or two sections, whereas the first one has about 10 sections. So it's a bit longer, which is partially why I decided to, you know, use it to kind of demo the game. And it's the most fun level in terms of just whacking away at enemies. Yep. Well, my urban climax is ready. So he's kind of like the first mid-boss. Oh man. You can see he's quite a bit tougher than a lot of the cannon fodder. Oh wait. See, his head is in the sword, and that's his weak spot, I guess you'd say. No! Jeez, son. Grab him. He can do that if he's sticking too near to his feet. I'll hopefully do it this time. It's actually my favorite of the climax effects. I don't know, butterfly or whatever. It just looks, I don't know, very fitting for me, and I think. It's a shame he grabbed me, because other than that, I would have done quite well on the old reward scale. Yeah, got a gold. Oh well. And here's another challenge. See, this level's got quite a lot of the challenges. I'm thinking this one's going to be the don't get hit. Yep, don't get hit. No. When I spin around like that, it's very Zelda, actually. You know, you think you do the spin attack. Well, I guess it's fishing that I'm wearing the Link costume.
You've been naughty.
Very naughty. Oh, there, I took out the gun. Fired away. I see Ashley's trying to get into the conversation as well. There's quite a few cutscenes, and most of them are actually fairly decent. When, whoops! I was really cut out by that guy. There we go. That's actually doing well. Obviously, Ashley agrees, though. Very much so. I'm thinking it was a hidden fight. Some of the fights, as I said, are completely optional, and oh, I can't skip this cutscene, which is sort of in-game engine, and yet they're having a conversation there, and it's like,
yeah,
walking away from you, walking away from you. Although I'm actually somewhat restricted. There's another cutscene later on where these two have a chat like this, and you can walk a mile off. In fact, I walk so far off that I managed to collect an item, and the item kind of collection sound couldn't kick in until this cutscene ended, and then as soon as it ended, it went and you bought the text. Oh, now I can skip this. There is some collectibles around here, but I've already done that, so on to the next fight. Whenever you see an open area, it pretty much means it's go time. I'm not sure I can use every climax there with everyone up in the air. Wait. Oh no! Sneaky archers! I usually have trouble with this fight. Well, there's the first one where they start to throw different combinations at you. And these little guys, while they're easy enough on their own, when you start to get other things mixed in with them, they can be just that nuisance, which is of course their point, but they're relatively weak. Happy rupees, because there's another mini boss coming in. Orbane. Skip. Skip to the end. You can actually take some of the enemy's weapons as well, and when you defeat this guy, you can take his weapons. Only for a limited time, but it's pretty cool. Again, it reminds me of the old school beat-em-ups, where you pick up fights and all sorts of stuff. I took up quite a few hits on that one, so... Oh, I meant to pick up... Pick up weapon. Oh, there we are. There we go. Knew I took too much damage. There's a shop again, but we'll skip it. I knew there was a guy here, which is why I brought those weapons, because he's kind of vulnerable to them for some reason. Well, who wouldn't be? They look fairly big and powerful. But he's just one guy on his own, and it counts as a kind of an extra verse in the game.
You've been naughty.
When you take it that weapon, you make it quite easy to get the platinum just way on him. So we're actually getting close to the end of the level now. Actually, we'll be pleased to hear. So, this is the boss. I don't know. Oh. It's weird that the confirm is on yes. Yeah. Oh no, why did I use that there? I just got lucky in the witch time there. I have got an add-on called Crow something or other, which means if you just are a little too late, you still get witch time. It's a very, very useful add-on. Well recommended from the shop. Or actually, no, it's not. It's not Crow. It's Bat Within. That's what it is. The Crow is the one that lets you fly, and that's very useful for collecting the crows in the game. So again, it's a lot of dodge and re-attack. But he's throwing out those icicle things. Great. I think I mentioned earlier on about the various kind of costumes and how they can change up the game slightly. If you play as Princess Peach. Instead of Bayonetta's regular, you know, punch, you do Bowser punches. Let's do this. That actually went pretty well. Couple of goals, but other than that, happy. We'll skip the cutscene again. Let's see what the end score is. You know the funny thing is, see three from the end on the kind of medals table? It shows a blank. Apparently there's a fight that I keep missing, and I don't know what it is. Yeah, that went pretty well. The combo might be down to last time. Yeah, so I was faster by a minute nearly. It's better overall, I think, because I got 3 goals last time, 2 goals this time, and more pure platinums. So we'll override. So, there we go. That's a look at Bayonetta 2 on the Wii U. It's a good game. I managed to get it reduced, so it kind of, you know, it's not something I would have paid full price for, but I was happy with, you know, paying 11 quid for it. I think it is a good game, and it certainly, I think if it had been on the other systems, would have gotten more attention than being on the Wii, you know, you kind of limited market. I definitely think if you got a Wii U, it's worth picking up now that it's reduced in price. If you haven't played Bayonetta 1 or 2, you might even try and get the double pack, but you can put Bayonetta very cheap on the PlayStation 3 or Xbox, so there's other ways to pick that one up and play it for a little money. But anyway, hope you enjoyed this look at another good Wii U game, and we'll see you again in another video shortly. Bye for now.